Several days ago, we posted the teardown of a brand new Apple 2040 watts cable. It's similar to the Volvo USB-C cable included in the iPhone 15 package. But actually, there were two different cables. Today, we will talk about the USB-C cable that comes with the iPhone 15. Let's see if there are any differences between those two cables. Like the 2040 watts cable, it adopts a Volvo design, and two USB-C connectors are white. There is no protective sleeve between the connector and the cable. We can find the model A2795 serial number on the USB-C connector. It does not adopt a full pin design, and the cable length is only about 1 meter. The diameter is about 3.17 millimeter, thinner than the Apple 2040 watts cable we talked about before. The overall weight is about 19 grams. Charging at power ZKM003C shows it does not have any marker chip. Then we did a voltage drop test, which can measure the difference between the input and output voltage. We found that the voltage drop falls into two categories, 0.19 and 0.58, slightly higher than the Apple 2040 watts cable. Use this cable to charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The power will be limited to 60 watts, which proves that it only supports up to 60 watts. Lastly, we connected this cable to a laptop and an SSD enclosure. The disk speed test shows the reading and writing speed is about 40 megabytes per second. So it's just a USB 2.0 cable. After a few simple tests, let's try to take it apart. First, let's cut off the USB-C connector. The top and bottom of the steel sleeve are protected by potting compound and a plastic ring, and is affixed by plenty of solder joints. There are several wires on the front of the PCB fixed by glue. The space is enough to solder an e-marker chip, but we cannot find it on the back. Next, we remove the metal shell of the USB-C connector. Those are two Apple-specific ground pins. The symmetrical gold-plated pins are beneath the plastic bracket, and it does not adopt a full pin design. The other USB-C connector has the exact same layout. It also has enough space to solder an e-marker chip on the back. Next, cut off the cable. The twisted structure on the woven layer keeps together even after being cut. Then cut off the TPE layer, and there is a layer of shielding net under it. There were a total of 6 wires inside, and some tensile fibers inside can improve its durability. Next, let's take a closer look at the wire design inside the cable. Those 3 red wires are used for positive power supply. The cores inside are made of tinned copper and there were no tensile fibers. The light blue wire is CC wire. The green and white wires correspond to D+ and D- wires used for USB 2.0 data transmission. Some bare tin copper wires are used for an active power supply. Except for those wires, these are the tensile fibers we talked about before. Well, that would be all wires and components of this cable. Compared to its previous generations, the woven design makes it more durable. After taking it apart, we found it lacks an e-marker chip and an aluminum foil layer compared to the Apple 2040 watts cable. So the maximum power can only reach 60 watts, and the cost will be lower. However, if you only use it to charge your iPhone, its overall build quality is still quite good. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!